Question 23. Again, this is a long question, so let me just try to read what we are looking for here. What is the statement coverage of these three tests? So it seems that they are giving us test cases, and we need to exercise those test cases against the flowchart in the diagram, and then we're going to count how many statements we have exercised through those test cases and calculate the statement coverage of the three tests. The graph here is the most important part in the questions. We have three test cases. We need to read the first test case and see how it will flow in the flow chart. Same thing with the second and third test cases. So I'm going to use my pen to go through the test cases. So you have to follow my pen to understand how the test cases are working. First test case, gold card holder who gets upgraded to business class. So we have to go from statement 1 down till statement 5. Second test case, non-gold card holder, so we have to go the first false of the first if statement, non-gold card holder who stays in economy. So we're going to go through statement 1, 6, and 7. Test case 3, a person who is bumped from the flight. So we're going to go through step 1, 6, 8, and 10. So as you see, test case 1 goes through steps 1, 2, 4, and 5. Test case 2 goes through statements 1, 6, and 7. Test case 3 goes through statements 1, 6, 8, and 10. If we count how many statements we have gone through, the question is asking how much statement coverage has been achieved running those three test cases. As you see, the graph already numbered the statement for us. We have a total of 10 statements. And if you count the statements under our drawing or under our pen, you will see that we run through statements total 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 10. A total of 80 statements. So we have exercised 80 statements out of 10 statements. That's 80%. So the correct answer is D, 80%. Question 24. Use case testing is useful for which of the following? And we have few options, and then we have answers, have some of those options. So we need to look at each option to make sure if it's true or false. Option P. Is use case testing useful for designing acceptance tests with users or customers? Correct. So if option P is correct, then the answer will be either A or B. Option Q won't help us to choose between answers A or B, as they both have option Q as correct. Option S or 4 will help us to choose the correct answer. Option R, finding defects in the interaction between components. Looks fine to me. Option S, identifying the maximum and minimum values for every input field. This is wrong because this is mainly regarding boundary value analysis, not use case testing. So the correct answer here should be B. To confirm our understanding, option Q should be correct, which is making sure that the mainstream business processes are tested. This is correct for use case testing. Identifying the percentage of statements exercised by a set of tests. Okay, this is wrong as it's related to white box testing, not use case testing. So the final answer is B. Question 25. Consider the following techniques. Which are static and which are dynamic techniques? And we have few techniques, and then in the answers, we have some of them static and some of them dynamic. So this should be an easy one. Pick an option that you're sure it's either 100% static or 100% dynamic. Technical review is a review technique which is 100% static. So if technical review is static, then the answer should be either A or B. And option 2 would help us answer the question. Use case testing is sure a dynamic testing technique, where we need to run the software. So the correct answer here should be A. To confirm, technical reviews and inspections are static testing techniques. Equivalence partitioning, use case testing, exploratory testing, and decision testing are dynamic testing techniques where we must run the software to perform.